That's a good circle. What y'all think? What y'all think about the circle? Y'all think it's?
I think it's move over on this side.
Yeah, good. I know everybody on their social distancing and everything. Yep. How is everybody feeling? Everybody feeling good? That's good. Glad you're feeling good. See that sun shining? That sun is definitely shining, shining, shining. Shining bright. It's very, very good to see you all. Brothers and sisters. So good to see y'all. So good to see y'all. I want to welcome y'all to the West Philly Peace Park. And everybody here know about the Peace Park.
I do.
Tell us about the Peace Park. Yes?
And then they also sell
the Green Wall Street. Black Market. That's right. And tell everybody your name. It's Aram, y'all. Give Aram a hand. Give him a black hand. Give Aram a black hand. Thank you, Aram. Thank you, thank you, thank you, folks. Thank y'all for coming out to our village walk. We are in West Philly today. And we are going to be doing what we do. As Africans, as original people, we're going to be taking the streets inside of our own communities, and we're going to be planting seeds, and we are going to be arousing spirit. So as land-based people, as sacred people, we don't start anything of importance without first giving due honor and due respect to the Creator and the ancestors. Because we all know that without the Creator, the Most High, and without the sacrifice of our ancestors, we couldn't be. So we'd always like to move in the spirit of Ubuntu, a spirit of oneness, a spirit of togetherness. So I want to ask from the queens that's present, which one of you would like to step forward and lead us in libation? Sister K, there's a setup. See, we tried to like, you know what I'm saying?
We got water. Anybody have any water
or anything? He got water.
The bottle water.
Oh, okay.
Wait, so new or
Jagnato?
Doesn't matter.
It really doesn't matter.
It got you.
You
need the
mic. I think I'm all right. It has Queen Essence's essence.
Well, give thanks for all the spirits and souls that have returned into this planet Earth, that have come today, in the spirit of blackness, in the spirit of oneness, in the spirit of love and honor to ourselves and each other. And we say Ashe.
Ashe.
I don't specifically want to call on any direct names. I just want to invoke the actual spirits that that assist us with the work of African liberation. We know that we have many ancestors, and not all ancestors work on the same level. Not all ancestors work in the same goal. So we want to call specifically those ancestors, those energies, those entities, those frequencies that assisted in African liberation, Ashe.
Ashe.
And we call those ancestors that were in pain, those ancestors that were lost in the Middle Passages during the Atlantic, the slave trades. May we call on those ancestors that lived within the United States specifically. May we call those ancestors that lived specifically in Philadelphia that worked towards the liberation of Africans. May we say Ashe.
Ashe.
And we call those ancestors that are making their grand return in the spirit of the unborn, right? May we call on those ancestors that are the cubs of Garvey. May we call on those ancestors that are making their ancestral return to this realm to help us fight and the work, not the struggle, not even the challenges, but the work of African liberation. Ashe.
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 Ashe. Ashe. Ashe.
Give thanks, African.
Give Sister K a black hand, folks. Black hand. Black hand. That's right, folks. That's right. So, brothers and sisters, you all know that we are in a serious predicament as a people. You all know that our people is suffering a very terrible oppression at the hands of enemies. We understand also too that from this oppression, so many problems derive from that. One of the problems that derive from that is the hate that's been pushed on us. We push that hate back on each other. One of the most nebulous forms of that hate is the killing and slaughtering of each other. I mean, just imagine being a people that has nothing and that's treated with violence. You're going to do that to each other, right? So even though we can't be blamed for the circumstance that we are in, we can definitely be held accountable, though, for getting out of it. The slave master is responsible for the conditions of the slavery. The slave ain't caused the slavery, the slave master did. But the slave is responsible for their liberation, though. We have experienced 2 years of a pandemic, right? And that so-called pandemic has hit our people harder than anybody. You got a terrible economic situation. You have a terrible political situation. And you have the poor suffering black folks who nobody wanted to show no love, even our own selves.
Put them in the wagon.
But you all and us and many more people that's not physically here with us today, we are the solution to it, though. Because we are black love personified. And as long as we got black love, an undying love for our people, a love for each other, we surely, surely, surely going to win. Ashe.
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 It's a beautiful thing that had got up this morning. It's a wonderful thing I got up out the bed this morning, y'all. You know what I'm saying? It's a beautiful thing I've got up out the bed. You know, I hope we went to the shower and the bath thing, the toothbrush thing. And I hope you took a look at yourself in the mirror, like, wow. It was wonderful to be able to depart from our abodes and then come here together at this place. This place, once again, is the Peace Park. And the Peace Park, we say, is a place for us. And the Peace Park is a little maroon that's carved out specifically, specially for our people, is to provide us Africans, us original people, with a little bit of what we are going to soon have a lot of. That's space, that's land, that's good food, that's good company, that's protection, money, love, and solidarity. That's what's coming to us. And the Peace Park is just a little bit to show me and you and us that that's all coming to us. Now look at it how we are, we brought up this peace part in the midst of captivity, in the midst of being surrounded by enemies. Even to this very moment right now, as we stand here at the peace park, you see that we're surrounded with some folks that are very, very much interested in what me and you are trying to do. But look at the miracle of how the sun is shining on us and we don't got no fear whatsoever for any enemies, anybody that wish us harm, of anybody who got bad vibes towards us. What I want you to know, I want you to know that when we stand up for ourselves, when we come together in a spirit of peace and unity, there's no force on this planet that can stop that. I want you today, as we walk out and as we go into West Philly, as we go into our neighborhood together, shoulder to shoulder, I want you to open yourself up to the spirit. Now, the thing about it, comrades and brothers and sisters, there's no other solution for the problems that our people face other than self-government. Y'all hear that? Self-government. There's no other solution to us running our own affairs all which ways. But there's another thing too, though. Did you all know that you are the sacred people of Almighty God? Did y'all know that? Did y'all know that? Did y'all know that you are the people that has come right along with that sun? When that sun was created, you likewise was created. When them trees was created, you likewise was created. The thing about it is this, folks. Almighty God, regardless of what name that you may call him or her, wants to perform miracles. He and she wants to do his or her work. Can you believe that? Out of our condition that we are in, we are about to have a government of peacekeepers. Ain't that's something else? Isn't it something that from all of this division and all of this disorganization that we have as a people, we actually about to snap to it, and it's actually about to be order, unity, togetherness? Could you believe that in the North Phillies, the West Phillies, the Badlands, the South Phillies, where there's so much killing and so much strife and so much ignorance and so much loss, how do it feel to know that that's about to change? It's about to change. The power that is present, the ultimate power that creates the reality that we all are part of, is just waiting for us to invite him or her to our circle. And that's what we did with our libation. So before we get going, I want to open up this circle to anybody who want to say any words of encouragement before we get going. Please feel free to speak your mind and to speak from your heart.
Together, there is nothing we cannot do.
Ashe.
I'm just so grateful to be here in the presence of so many people that are fighting this fight. And I hope to get to know everyone. I hope to get to, like, really share and hear by you all here, because I know why I'm here, and it's for the love of my people, for the love of Black people. And I know you guys have the same love, and I just feel like having the opportunity to share it with people is what is going to bring us to the light and what is going to really make a change and a difference in our community.
Ashe.
Ashe.
Remember to stay in power, move with love, and we're doing this for the youth. And to bring peace and love into our community. So as we're walking, stay close to love. Stay close to positivity. Stay in your power. of them.
Yeah.
How much we have their back. They may think they're alone out here, but this is why we're here. Again, together. This is what it is.
I do want to say that beyond just like this contribution, there are a number of different ways that we can support different initiatives. I know Brother Frosty has been posting on Instagram a number of different outlets, including Brother Ruben's, where the fathers are outside assisting children, you know, get back and forth to school safely. There's just a number of different initiatives in which we can actually become more actively and intentionally involved in securing our people, most especially the children, because this is really what this is all about, is protecting our children. Let it be more of a comfortable and frequent flowing conversation to say, how can I be there for you today?
Ashe. All right, folks, one more thing.
Good.
Everybody might not know everybody, so let's just get on a first name basis. My name is Brother Tommy. You know what I'm saying? That we can just go around. Everybody can just introduce themselves. Peace be unto y'all.
Will you close? Peace and love, everybody. I'm sorry.
Go ahead,
I'm Kay.
Hey,
I'm
Kay.
Hey,
Brother
Macy.
Tyra.
Sister, be heavenly.
One more time?
Oh.
Brother Peely.
It's Brother Omawala.
Okay, folks. One black family, y'all. All right, folks. So, we are going to get going. We're going to let the Spirit lead us. We wanted drummers out here with us today, but I think it was a problem with them making it in time. So, we just want to go ahead and just let it rock out. Our first stop is Overbrook. So, we're going to be taking a route. So, brothers, everybody look out for everybody, but definitely the brothers will be looking out very strongly for anything that's going down. We, on that table right there, we do have some banners. We do have some flags. We also got a clipboard. So as we out meeting people, if folks want to get involved with this movement, make sure that we get their phone number, their contact information. because we're going to be following up. One of the ideas that we are trying to implant is the idea of a week of peace around Thanksgiving. You know, Thanksgiving is always a time where it's like, I know for my family, like it's the most warm. It's the most time when we actually kind of get together, despite the colonial, you know what I'm saying, whatever, the holiday. You know how black people, we take stuff and we flip it though. But the idea that we're looking at is what we call a 10-10-10 program. We're talking about focusing on 10 blocks, and we're talking about raising up 10 teams of 10 people. And if we can focus on 10 blocks time after time, we can put into place security. We can put into place the machinery that will keep the peace. And if we can have that little victory of stopping the killings and stopping the shootings in one area, we can then build off of that. No solution other than a black government, folks. A black government of peacekeepers to maintain our own security. That's what we need. That's what our focus is, y'all. So y'all ready to roll out?
So,
Sister Vic.
As we're getting ready to roll out, you know, it's Brother Tommy, so we're going to have the drums and stuff. Yeah. But for us to head out, we want to let Sister Heavenly start us off with something for the parents and inspiration. And then we'll
I just want to say, first of all, like, just, you know, continue to be a light. I see the light in all of you. So continue to be a light to your community, to your family, your friends. You know, shine that light that the Most High placed within you on every single person that you meet. And show them that, because we are the chosen people, we're going to guide everyone back to the Most High and understanding that we do need peace. We do need unity. But it's only through us. We're the gatekeepers. We're the peacekeepers. So, I wanted to read this poem that I wrote a few years back when one of my friends was murdered, and after I had a few other family and friends, victim of gun violence. It's called 143 Miles of Pain.
Do you want the mic? Yeah.
The mic?
I'll hold it for. Yeah.
I was about to say, I can't hold it. Can y'all hear me? Can I be heard? Oh, it's not on. Alright, can I be heard? Press this button. Okay, y'all can hear me now. Yeah, I know I'm soft and spoken, so. This poem is called 143 Miles of Pain. Welcome to the city of brotherly love, where the killings are senseless, where they think a Xan and a perk will cure their mental illness. The mothers are crying, their babies are dying, yet y'all don't hear this. No, y'all don't feel this, but that ain't nothing new. We've been conditioned since the day they made us watch our loved ones swing from the noose. Mm. But somehow we're never the victims when you hear it on the news. We did this to ourselves. We self-inflicted or deserve the abuse. Bullish. I cannot do this. How many times must we go through this? Another day, another body, ain't nothing new since that is all we see. And it's like us raising hell in the streets is a nuisance, but we can't just let it be. I'm so sick of the city, man. I'm so sick. Was it over some digits? Was it over some chick? You acted tough, you got a gun, so now you trying to prove-ish. Now your nut act looking dumb cause you missed. But you killed somebody else's kid, who ain't have nothing to do with it. You took their lives, and now yours too, serving a life sentence when both y'all could've squashed that ish, lived y'all lives, and made a difference. Common sense ain't so common when it comes to money, drugs, or women. Not worried about the common, lost in the sauce of street business, not worried about the consequences. Now everybody's gotta pay for your whack ass feelings. Nah, y'all bugging. That ain't real thugging. Y'all must be on that thugging love tip. Mm. Can't wait to get a pump in. Can't wait to be shackled up with your cellmates on your bottom bunking. Cause that's where that ish leads. When you kill somebody's son over desires and greed. When there was more than enough in the pot for both of y'all to eat. I'm in disbelief that the streets could be so weak. Crutching on cane cause you're not able to create your wealth without stealth. Street proverbs say hating is bad for your health. Y'all look like clowns or a bunch of crabs in the barrel trying to pull the city down. Into the blood of our lost ones, we drown. Been searching for L-O-V-E in the 143 miles, but I'm lost in the city of brotherly love where there's no love to be found. Not safe at home, not safe at school, or on the playgrounds. But no fear in the air after you hear the first round. Just anxious waiting, patience taken from the news crowd. I even got a few friends and families whose homicides made the news now. Nothing to brag about though. Just some tear-stained obituaries and a few photos to show. The new seeds that have been sown now infecting the city's soul. And it hurts me to say this, but we gotta forgive and let that go. But know that each tear shed matters, for that's where a new garden will grow. And in that garden lies a cure to heal each broken home, to heal each broken family, to heal each broken soul. Love is the key to the city that we all call home. Whether friend or foe, whether sis or bro, we gotta stop all the violence and gain some self-control. Cause lamppost vigils and candlelights only last for so long, only burn but so bright after the angels take flight. I often find it harder to sleep at night. Gunshots and sirens roaming around the city, ghosts aplenty, like a haunted crypt where goblins and ghouls come to play. Thank you.
Ashay.
Ashay.
Shalom, everyone.
Shalom. How?